Guys, welcome to Meterics. Today we'll be having a look at the Benetech digital carbon monoxide meter. This is the GM8805 model to be exact, and as you can see, it's a very simple, very small, compact and very portable carbon monoxide meter. So this is quite handy to have along with you because you can easily take it anywhere, whether you'll be testing for carbon monoxide anywhere around your house, around the office, in the garage, or you just keep it in the car. It's quite handy and quite useful. It fits perfectly. As you can see from the size, it's got just a carbon monoxide sensor up top, an LCD screen, and a three button layout, which is very simple, and they're all in orange, so very easy to see. What we're going to do is we're going to quickly power it up and just make sure the batteries are in. You just put the batteries in the back and then push the power button. As soon as you do that, it comes up and you will see it has the temperature reading here, and then it has a 10 second countdown for the carbon monoxide. So what that does is during the 10 seconds, it activates the sensors and tries to detect for any carbon monoxide presence in the environment that you're in. So it's pretty simple. As you can see, it's got a scan button here, and what this does, this changes the mode the meter is in. Right now it's on scan, and what this means is it will spontaneously show the readings that it detects carbon monoxide. So if we walk in one part of the room and the reading will go high. As soon as we walk away or there's a wind blowing past and blows away the carbon monoxide, it will immediately drop. So that's what scan means. It's just random spontaneous readings that it detects at the time. Push the scan button again and it goes to hold. Now hold is quite useful when you're in a room where the carbon monoxide levels are not very stable. So if you push hold, what that does, that freezes with the value that is currently on screen. So if the value was high, you press hold, it will freeze on that. And regardless whether the carbon monoxide level does drop, the value will not drop. So it's basically what that does. It holds it, so you freeze it. It freezes the value. You can write it down or do whatever you want to do. Next, we push that again. Then we get the max setting. Now the max setting, this will pick up and show the highest value that you get. The highest amount of carbon monoxide it detects, that is what is going to be displayed. Then you push it again, goes to average, and average, it's going to average out the carbon monoxide levels that it has detected for that entire time that it's been on. So if it's been 20 minutes, it will not show the current levels of carbon monoxide, but the average amount of carbon monoxide within those 20 minutes. So that's what that does. You push it again and you go back to scan and it's on spontaneous random movements. Now this power button is also the backlight, so just in case you can't see clearly, just push that and it turns the backlight on, a very bright white light, so making it very easy to see. Next we have the set button, and what this does, this is where you set your limits. We have the high limit currently set at 100 ppm and a low limit set for 50. So it's quite easy because you can change those limits according to your requirements or your needs. So making it very easy to use meter. So that's it for today, guys. On a separate video, we will be testing for carbon monoxide in a controlled environment. So we'll get to see the levels go up and down and, we'll get to see it fluctuate. And we'll get to test those limits, so it's going to be a more interesting video, and we'll be testing all the good stuff. I hope to see you again in that next video, but that's all for today. So just to quickly turn it off, you simply push and hold the power button for a second, it says off, and the meter is off. So that's it for today, guys.